Welcome to the Simple Sophisticate Podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. I'm your host, Shannon Abels. And whether you're listening on your commute, exercising, working in the garden, or sitting down with a hot cup of tea or a cafe au lait, thank you for tuning in. Let's get started. Welcome to the 260th episode of The Simple Sophisticate. And we have our first episode of just me and you listening and talking. And I'm excited to dive into this episode because it is about decor. And I have a feeling it's going to be the first of many decor episodes because, as many of you already know, if you follow me on Instagram or have stopped by the blog, The Simply Luxurious Life has a new home. The boys and I have bought our first home in Bend, and I am still pinching myself. I am also very exhausted, and my hands ache from weeding the boulevards that I have, but I have boulevards to weed, and I am so excited about that. I was just talking to my neighbors as I was out weeding this evening, and they were talking about, as a couple of other neighbors have told me, that the flax that blooms in late spring, early summer is something that the rest of the neighborhood really enjoys seeing. It's beautiful. And I couldn't help but think that France had found its way to me here in Bend in many ways, because when I visited, as many of you know, France last summer, I had the opportunity to learn a little bit more about the linen fields, the flax fields, in Normandy through and from Sharon Santoni. And I love linen, and I love the history of linen, and I love where it comes from. And the fields are delicate and beautiful, and they only last for a few weeks. And I have a little bit of that at my home, and I cannot wait. So I am going to be exploring decor, and today's episode is all about simple, significant decor ideas to add luxurious touches to your home. It's going to be titled Part One because there are going to be more in the coming months of that, I have no doubt. I don't know when they will come, but I have a stack of new decor books that just came out this fall that I'm pouring through, and today's episode is entirely inspired by one of those books, but only part of the book because there's so much that I'm gathering from it. So that is what we're going to talk about today. But before I get into that, this week's petit plaisir is for the Anglophiles out there. And it was one that I discovered just this weekend and was truly delighted that it was available this weekend. So I'll share with you that at the end of today's episode. But now let's get into today's episode. 10 simple, significant decor ideas to add luxurious touches to your home. Part Un. The first book that inspired this episode is a book written by interior designer Kathy Kincaid. And her new book is called The Well-Adorned Home. And you can see the cover of the book on today's show notes. I've also pulled images from the book to demonstrate what we're talking about in these, in many of these points today. So be sure to stop by the show notes for those ideas. The simplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast260. And I have a feeling there will be a second episode that's inspired by her book alone, because she has so much, as I mentioned at the top of this episode, to share when it comes to inspiration for decor. Now, a lot of her decor involves different wallpapers and prints and patterns, but I think that's something to not be afraid of. And I think a lot of us stick to simple palettes and solid colors because they're safer. I am guilty of that. I've done that. And I think that's okay. I don't think it's a bad thing. I think that's probably how we start if we're cautious in our decor. But once we become more confident in our decor, if we want a touch of personality, and it doesn't have to be bright and flamboyant if that's not who we are, but I think once we discover that pattern can be powerful in small or big places, that we just need to learn how to incorporate it. And she does a good job of teaching the reader that in her book. So I wanted to start off before I get to the 10 pieces of inspiration of advice by sharing some bullet point advice commentary from Kathy Kincaid that came from the book. And she states, quote, "Everyone wants to have nice things, but houses are meant to be lived in. And I'm insistent they feel cozy and appropriate for clients and their lifestyle." That to me resonated. That was in her introduction when she shared that, because she's right. We all love beauty and everyone has a different definition of what beauty is, but we also want to be able to just be in our homes. I was moved by so many of readers' comments on Instagram and on the blog when I shared the news of my home, because so many of you guys shared your stories as well about how you feel in your home and the moment you first started to live in your home, whether it was last year or 30 years ago. And one reader actually shared something that I have a feeling I'll be doing a lot of, and I already have been doing a lot of throughout my life, but that her home is her sanctuary where she loves to just be and be with her dogs and not have to go outside in the world if that's just not what she wants to do. And it's not that she doesn't want to be outside in the world. I didn't get that from her comment at all. What I got was that she finds great comfort and rejuvenation in her home. And she spent a great deal of time creating that space so that it does feel that way. And I think that's the power of what a well-decorated home can be. And that can only be something that the individuals who live in that home can cultivate. And it does take time. All right. So that's her first tip of advice for decor. Second one is to buy the best that you can afford, whether it's furniture, design elements. So that might be the lighting, that might be different structures in the house, different utilities or tools, sinks. I mean, those things that you need, but also that you love. Invest in what you can best afford, as well as accessories. So the details, the decor items, those little things that make a big difference. Not, as she says, not for investment or resale projections, but rather for quality and timelessness. That is a shift to keep in mind, that it shouldn't be, well, I know that if I buy this, it will be able to be sold later. Sometimes we do have to let go of that and just invest in what brings us comfort. We may have it for the rest of our lives. We don't know. But what if we do live in this house for 30 years? Don't you want a chair that you can, you know, cozy into for those 30 years? So invest in something that you love and that will last. So really, you know, finding that foundational concept of the simply luxurious life, quality over quantity, as much as you can afford. The third one is something that's very powerful but often forgotten about. She mentions lighting sets the tone and determines if there will be a cultivated, inviting ambiance. So this also, as much as it includes actual lights and lamps and sconces and pendant lightings and all the things that we think of when we think of lighting, she also makes sure that we don't forget about mirrors and chandeliers. Because just having that glass creates different use of light in a space. I love having mirrors in my house. In fact, I think I have too many mirrors when I moved here, and I actually have a few that I don't know where I'm going to put them because I feel like I can see myself constantly. And it's not that I'm vain. I actually don't like looking in a mirror all that much, but it does bring a lot of light to a space. The next thing she simply says is edit, edit, edit. And that can be very, very hard. And that's part of the process that does just take time. And we evolve and we progress, and it's okay to let go in our own way. The next thing she suggests is take time, relax, and enjoy the work. Oh, what a practice this is. It's not easy, is it? I think it's easier as we get into our space and we find great comfort in it and we just take our time. But as of right now, as I'm moving in, I want to get it situated. I want to get into it. I want to be able to be comfortable. But I also want to be able to breathe and be able to function. And that means I need to take time and rest. But I think that's also something that if we rush things, we make bad decisions. So even if we are 10 years in the process of living in a home, we don't want to rush the process of deciding or finding what we're looking for. That perfect piece may be something you'll never be able to find in a traditional store. It may be something that you are going to find on your travels that you didn't expect, but when you see it, you just know. So enjoy where you are in the journey of your home and your sanctuary, and just examine and explore what it is you're trying to cultivate as you move forward, and keep an open mind as you travel or go about your life, and you will find those items. You will. And the last piece of advice that I want to share with you is from Kathy Kincaid, is to create some tension when it comes to color and discover how to match colors imperfectly, thus creating that tension. I thought this was clever. She shares how this was something that took her time to figure out, and she was taught herself by one of her mentors how to do this, because she was someone who had to match all the colors perfectly according to the rules. And as you will see, if you look in her book and at some of these pictures, her rooms aren't chaotic. They aren't shocking. But you might go, wait a second, I would have never thought to put that pattern with this or that or the other. There's still some thought and some balance to everything that she does, but it doesn't all have to be matchy-matchy. And I have learned through my own experience that that can be something that just doesn't speak of the individuals that live in a home for me. So that's just something to maybe, hopefully she'll give you permission to just let go of that idea of perfect. All right. So those are some items of advice that she gives, and I've listed them on the show notes if you want to take a look at them again. But let's take a look at 10 decor ideas that I discovered in Kathy Kincaid's new book, The Well-Adorned Home. I have, as I said, included the images from a handful of these points from the pages of her book, and I'm excited to get further into it. I think she's going to be inspiring even more episodes as we move forward. All right. Number one is add classic molding. So crown moldings to the room, especially when you have small spaces, to raise the ceiling. Now, this might sound counterintuitive, because you're like, wait a second, it's bulking up the room, it's filling up space. And again, we're talking about crown moldings that go between the top part of the wall and then against the ceiling. But I can attest this is true. In my previous home that I owned, I remodeled the bathroom, and it was a bathroom that was literally 5 feet by 7 feet. And I painted it white, so I painted it a light color, and I had some very light beige tile, Italian tile. And so there was a little bit of color, but not a lot. And then I put some grand crown moldings, classic crown moldings, on the ceiling in the corners as I went around the wall, and it really did elevate the room. It almost pulled it up. It was like it almost just pulled it up. It pulls your eye up. So something to think about, especially if you have a small room and you want to make it seem larger. Number two, expand a small space by using one pattern throughout. Here's a quote from Kathy Kincaid, if you're a suspect about whether or not this is a good idea. She says, most people think that pattern will overwhelm a room. That can happen if a pattern is used piecemeal, but the opposite is true when there's continuity. And this is a piece of decor wisdom that I would have never done at the beginning of my decor experiments, I guess you could say, because I would have thought, no, it's going to make the room seem smaller. Well, obviously it does depend on the right pattern and print, and most likely, and you'll see different ideas that she has in her book and the images I share, they're often lighter prints in these big rooms, or small rooms, excuse me, but not always. And it's that continuity that kind of creates a monotone look that creates a bigger space in the mind's eye. So it's very paradoxical. It's actually kind of fascinating. So again, if you've been wanting to dabble in pattern, but you have a small space, go for it. You can do it. Number three, the power of pairs. I love this. I stick to this as much as my budget can afford. Especially in small spaces, she says, avoid the cluttered look. In other words, instead of having two different chairs or five different chairs, just have two grand chairs that are exactly the same upholstery or design. Same thing with lamps. Have two paired lamps. Have two paired side tables or night tables, coffee tables, wherever the room is. it actually does create a more solidified look and reduces the look of clutter, because you probably do want two lamps or you do want two chairs if you're at your dinner table or your bistro table. So especially in a small space, something to keep in mind. It adds a bit of eclectic charm, but at the same time, it creates a solidarity. And there's a lovely little picture of from her book of two striped armchairs for the dining room that she has in her book. And I've provided that on the show notes. Number four, balance pattern and solids. If the walls have a statement pattern wallpaper, choose solid upholstered furniture. And vice versa, if your furniture is upholstered and has prints, stick to a solid wall color or covering. It doesn't have to be paint, but it can be wallpaper. It might be a textured wallpaper that's solid color. That's a great way to bring in something that's a little bit different. But try to balance the amount of prints you have in a room. And I think that's a very smart idea that adds a unique signature touch. And I have a picture of that in the show notes that she exemplifies. Five, choose comfortable dining chairs. In other words, for your dining table, choose chairs that are upholstered or padded in some way so that it encourages your dinner party guests to linger. Oh, this is so true. And first of all, I love sitting at my own dining room table for my breakfast and whenever I'm on my own or just with one individual. And it just, you get to relax when you sit there. Maybe it's just me, but hard chairs are hard to sit in, and I'd rather go sit at on a sofa or an armchair. But I really like to eat, and I want conversation, and I want people to feel comfortable to stay and enjoy their food in the conversation. So when you can afford it, when you're able to, what a great idea. Find dining room chairs that are comfortable. So those are the first five ideas of simple, significant ways to add luxurious touches to the home. I'm going to be right back after I introduce you to the sponsors for today's episode. Did you know that it takes 20 tons of earth mining to produce a single ring of gold? That's why brands refuse to tell where their gold comes from. That's why Ana Luisa uses 100% recycled gold in all of their products. Ana Luisa offers jewelry at fair prices that are accessible for their customers. Big brands will charge you 10 times the cost of production, but Ana Luisa eliminates the retail markup. With jewelry that comes from the same jewelers as Tiffany's and Louis Vuitton, they are so confident in their quality that they offer a complimentary one-year warranty on every product. I have had the opportunity to wear Ana Luisa jewelry, and wearing their simple gold necklace with all sorts of outfits, from my jeans and a button-up collared shirt to dresses that I'm enjoying wearing this last summer as well as I move into the school year. This is a quality product that will add that simple touch without overwhelming the outfit you have. Truly classic that will last for years. As a Simple Sophisticate listener, you have the opportunity to check out their designs and save money when you make your first purchase. Visit analuisa.com/simplesophisticate and enjoy perusing their collection. Again, that's Ana Luisa, analuisa.com/simplesophisticate. With HelloFresh, America's number one meal kit, get easy seasonal recipes and pre-measured ingredients delivered right to your door. All you have to do is cook and enjoy. HelloFresh makes cooking delicious meals at home a reality, regardless of your comfort in the kitchen. Say goodbye to endless grocery store trips and takeout food. HelloFresh has you covered. Break out of your dinner rut with HelloFresh's 20-plus seasonal chef-curated recipes each week. And HelloFresh has more 5-star recipes than any other meal kit, so you know you'll get something delicious. Add extra meals to your weekly order, as well as yummy add-ons like garlic bread and cookie dough, and easily change your delivery days, food preferences, and even skip a week whenever you need. Having had the opportunity to cook with HelloFresh, their ingredients are seasonal and fresh, delicious, and every meal that I've cooked has been made in fewer than 30 minutes. Delicious, and it teaches me something. So that's something that is a takeaway that I appreciate as well. Now, as a Simple Sophisticate listener, you have the opportunity to earn $80 off your first month of HelloFresh. Go to HelloFresh.com/Sophisticate80 and enter Sophisticate80. Again, save $80 off your first month of HelloFresh when you go to HelloFresh.com/Sophisticate80 and enter Sophisticate80. So let's get back into home decor and how to add simple yet significant luxurious touches. Number six, I like this one and I'm actually starting to do this now. I haven't done it for yet, but I'm looking at some of my lampshades. I'm thinking, yep, this would be a great idea. Number six is select bespoke lampshades to add a signature touch. This is a very simple way to keep what you primarily have, the base of your lamps that you love, but add some texture, add some personality, add a bit of a statement piece. Now you could even make them yourself if you're so inclined, but it also just means go to a vintage shopping store, go to a consignment store, go to that one luxurious decor store that you've always wanted to buy something at, but you can't afford too much there, if anything at all, and see what kind of lampshades they have. And then ask around and maybe you can buy just a lampshade and not the base. Usually you can. So just keep your eyes open. And those simple little touches that you make like this to a lampshade can make a significant difference to your home. Number seven, I love this idea. My mom does this in the guest room where I go to every holiday in my guest room at home, my childhood home. Include a luggage rack in your guest room. Now, there's a lot of different reasons to do this. Not everyone has a large guest room. And so providing the space for them to just open their luggage up right there, because maybe there's not a closet available, or maybe the closet is full with your stuff. Hey, that's what I do in my closets most of the time. This is a way to also just let them know they're welcome in this space and it's easy and accessible for them to get to their luggage without having it on the floor. So it makes them feel special. So that's number seven. Number eight, include some open shelves in the kitchen to provide ease of access for frequently used dishes, oils, and spices. I love this one. And in fact, I'm trying to figure out how to do it in my kitchen here. I've had open shelves before in my previous home, and I really liked it because it opened the space up as this point shares. I wouldn't have all of my cupboards open because there's some things you just don't want open. If you have a lot of cupboard space, you can, you know, hide some things and keep your pantry food, you know, in dark covered spaces for all your olive oils and things like that. But I think having a few intentional open spaces is a really luxurious way of demonstrating maybe your collection of oils from your travels, or, you know, that you're a cook and having it easily accessible to your stovetop, or beautiful dishes, but dishes that you use regularly so you don't have to dust that shelf because you're using things regularly. Because that's the only thing that I've heard from people as to why they don't want shelves. They don't want to dust it. Totally understand that. Makes sense to me. But if you're using it, you're less likely to have to dust them. So just something to keep in mind. That's number eight. Number nine, convert a beloved table into a kitchen island or workspace by adding either a cutting board top or marble top to the surface. Now, there's a great picture in the show notes of this. This woman actually, they had the table that was from the previous owner of this home in Europe, and she converted it and just added a beautiful marble top to it, and it's in the center of her kitchen. And it looks like it was meant to be there, but it was completely up to her to create it. And it's something that you don't have to buy a brand new table. And so just keep your eyes open at, you know, garage sales, estate sales, consignment shops, things like that. And then just add the top to make it a workspace. Number 10, layer rugs on top of one another to make the room feel larger. Again, another idea I would never have thought of, but it really makes sense. And there's a picture of one from the book, but there's many more in her book of this idea. You'll want to place the neutral rug, whether you have hardwood floors or carpet, make it the largest one. So it's going to be in the bottom. And then put any additional rugs on top that are patterned or have a more of a mixture of colors. And it really does, you can create obviously different spaces in the room, but it does create layers and depth for a room. So those are the 10 ways to add simple yet significant luxurious decor touches to your home. As I go about examining and considering how to add my own signature style to my new home, and as well as I follow Kathy Kincaid's advice to make sure it creates a cozy home that fits with my lifestyle, I look forward to sharing what I discover and letting you interpret it the way that works best for you in your lifestyle and what you are passionate about. So do look for part deux or part two to be shared in the coming weeks here on the podcast. And I will continue to go through all my decor books. But this first decor book again was Kathy Kincaid's A Well-Adorned Home that just came out this September. I'll provide a link to that book. So be sure to visit the show notes, thesimplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast260. I've also included three archive episodes and posts about decor that share even more ideas for decorating from over the years. So be sure to stop by the show notes to see those. And I'll be right back with this week's Petit Plaisir. So I was delighted when I discovered this Petit Plaisir, and I knew it was coming, but I didn't know when it was going to be available. All right, my British baking show fans. Yes, indeed, it is back on Netflix. We already knew that season 10 was premiering in the UK in the late last week of August. But I thought we would have to wait until that season was entirely done airing in the UK, but no! Season 10 is now available on Netflix. It just became available a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, the end of August as well. So not that long after the UK version. And they're releasing one a week. So only two are available as of this weekend. So we get to slowly enjoy it, which is not a bad thing either. Needless to say, I had a great day, but I was exhausted. And this is what's funny, the silly little things that just kind of irk you. I was watching the men's U.S. Open final with Nadal, and my recording didn't keep taping because it went into at least five sets. I don't know how many because it didn't keep taping. And I was like, oh, that's what I wanted to end my weekend with. And anyway, I was like, shoot, darn, I'll look online to see who won. But I won't spoil it here in case you're wondering. but then I found this on Netflix and I was delighted. And I watched the first episode last night. So anyway, for all of my fellow British baking show fans, the 10th season, they've been at this for 10 years now, is available on Netflix. But on Netflix, just know that it's labeled as season 7 because they don't have the first three episodes or first three seasons. But season 7 on Netflix is a new episode that just or is still airing in the UK. Here is the trailer for the series, or the season, I should say.
On your marks.
Get set.
Bang!
The judges are ready.
Back to the drawing board.
You look a bit nervous.
The hosts are ready.
Just throw food colouring at it.
And the bakers are raring to go.
He's doing the bake-off thing. Does it work?
No.
It's that time of year again.
Really?
This is not a good face, this face here.
Don't panic!
Nailed it!
Just inedible.
It was pretty awful.
Ah. That was a happy sound.
The Great British Bake Off is back.
Mayhem is the best word for it.
Starting Tuesday at 8 on Channel 4.
So that was clearly the trailer that would be airing in the UK. But again, it's airing here now. I love the opening of the first episode as they're all dressed up in the Wizard of Oz costumes. And they actually do a flashback of all previous 9 winners. Some I didn't even know because in America, we haven't seen the first 2 series or seasons, excuse me. But it's a lovely little playful intro, and I think you'll enjoy it if you haven't already seen it. And I'll provide a link to that on Netflix on the show notes, thesimplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast260. podcast 260. Now, before I wrap up today, I just wanted to remind you that the season premiere of season 2 of the Simply Luxurious Kitchen just premiered this last weekend. And I went to France. Susan Herman Loomis had a segment or cameo on it as well. And I even showed a glimpse of a recent trip to the coast with my dogs. So be sure to check that out. I want to thank everyone who shared themselves either viewing the show. It was fun to see you as well as your dogs or your kids. And then also some of you have already made this recipe and shared how it went. It sounds like it went very well. So thank you for sharing and tagging me on Instagram, The Simply Luxurious Life. And if you feel like tagging me as well, I will be sharing yours in the future potentially. I hope you enjoy this week's Petit Plaisir, where each week ideas are shared to make the everyday all the more enjoyable. Tune in at the end of each episode where I'll recommend a book, a film, a show, a recipe, anything that is a simple pleasure to satiate your sophisticated taste. Thank you very much for tuning in today, and I hope you have a wonderful week. I'll be back next Monday. Thank you for tuning in to the Simple Sophisticate podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. For more ideas and inspiration throughout the week, visit the blog, thesimplyluxuriouslife.com, or pick up my new book, Living the Simply Luxurious Life, Making Your Everydays Extraordinary and Discovering Your Best Self. You can also pick up my first book, Choosing the Simply Luxurious Life, A Modern Woman's Guide, which is available now in paperback, ebook, and audio versions on Amazon, Audible, and iTunes, or wherever books are sold. To stay caught up on the most recent episodes of the podcast, blog posts, my new cooking show, and receive exclusive news as well as an extra dose of inspiration to jumpstart your weekend, subscribe to the Simply Luxurious Life's weekly newsletter, which arrives in your inbox each Friday to enjoy with a hot cup of tea or a morning cup of coffee. Until next Monday, I'm your host, Shannon Ables. Bonjour.